Okay, I can't be the only person who watched Firebreather growing up. So I was recently talking to a friend of mine, and while reminiscing over the cartoons we watched as kids, I brought up Firebreather, and he had no clue what I was talking about. So, to make sure it wasn't just some fever dream, I looked up the film, and a surge of nostalgia rushed through my body. So then I decided to sail the seven seas and watch the film once again, and now I'm making a video about it. Firebreather is a TV film about a kid named Duncan. Now, Duncan isn't your average teenager. He's the same tint as Donald Trump and he eats charcoal for breakfast. Why? Well, he's half kaiju. For some pretext, the film takes place on an Earth that is inhabited by kaiju. There was a huge war 16 years prior between the kaiju and the humans. The war was only put to an end when Duncan's mom, Margaret Rosenblatt, stood up to the king of the kaiju, Balak. Her actions mesmerized Balak, and not only did he stop rampaging, but he also gave her a baby. Since then, there hasn't been any kaiju sightings, and Margaret and Duncan have been constantly moving and have just relocated to the southwest in what has to be Nevada or Colorado. Duncan is transferring to Herbert Hoover Howell High, and on his first day, he's introduced to Jenny, the popular girl who he instantly falls for, Isabel, the edgy girl who's obsessed with kaiju, as well as Duncan, and Kenny, the weird loner type who's in love with Isabel and is voiced by Dante Bosco. While dissecting a frog during biology class, Duncan notices something out of the ordinary, a Gomorrodon, a mini kaiju that's been mistaken for a frog. Luckily though, he's able to save the Gomorrodon while simultaneously cementing himself as a weirdo. However, this discovery is worrisome because kaiju and their descendants haven't been seen in over a decade. Now, since Duncan is the son of the king of the kaiju and the only kaiju half-breed, he is constantly monitored by the government. Margaret and the government have an agreement to where they can keep tabs on Duncan as long as he gets a normal life, aside from being half kaiju, of course. Blitz is the agent tasked with surveilling Duncan. He fronts as the school's gym teacher and also has a jet disguised as a school bus. Blitz has a disdain for Duncan, which he makes sure Duncan is aware of. Also, he talks like your average bro, which compels the viewer to hate him, but I don't, because he's trying to smash Duncan's mom.
Be happy to give you my 2 cents about him over dinner sometime.
The movie itself revolves around Duncan trying to assimilate to his new school, but as always, trouble seems to steer his way. And after trying to evade a bully named Troy, his powers surface when he's cornered and starts breathing fire. Blitz covers up the incident and takes Duncan to his personal physician slash scientist at the military base, who essentially tells them it's just puberty. After that incident, Duncan is invited to a party by Isabel, and the only reason he goes is because Jenny is gonna be there. When he gets there, he starts simping for Jenny as soon as he sees her. And because Jenny lost the money for homecoming and everyone hates her, she's vulnerable and entertains him. Not too long after, Troy, who's supposed to be grounded, comes to the party and warns Jenny about Duncan. But before he can finish, his dad barges in and, let's just say he seems to be like the tough love type of father. Duncan makes a comment about how Troy probably hates his dad and would love for him to just disappear. Jenny then all of a sudden looks disparaged and tells Duncan she's leaving, making it obvious that her dad's dead. By the way, I feel like the whole talking about parents around someone with dead parents is just so played out. Anyway, suddenly there's a myriad of Gomorrodons attacking the party, and lo and behold, Balak, the man, well, kaiju himself, appears and begins to wreak havoc. While hiding behind a car with Isabel, Duncan reveals to her that Balak is actually his father and is most likely here for him, which proves to be the case. So, to save Isabel and everyone else, he goes along with Balak to his secret lair, and that's where the film starts to pick up. It turns out that Balak's time as the king of the kaiju is running up, and as his son, Duncan must take on the mantle as well as the other kaiju that want to kill him for that title. Balak would then throw Duncan in a pit of lava that would increase his kaiju powers, but Duncan rejects his call to action, making it very clear that he doesn't care to be the king of the kaiju shortly before passing out. Duncan would wake up in the middle of the desert looking as he did before he was thrown in the lava, and with a crystal in his pocket. He ends up making it to Kenny's house, which is just a caravan. After seeing that what had happened has been reported on the news, Duncan also notices that Kenny is living in deplorable conditions. And when he asks him about his family, it's clear that Kenny's father is neglecting him and only shows up when it's convenient. Fast forward, and Duncan is treated like a hero when he gets back to school because Isabel told everyone that he saved her at the party. He also gives that crystal to Jenny, which she sells to fund the homecoming dance. All seems well, and Duncan is finally having a normal life. He is liked by his peers, he has a set of good friends, and possibly even a girlfriend. The final act consisted of Duncan going to the dance and having his true identity revealed to everyone by a jealous Kenny. Everyone starts turning on Duncan, and Kenny quickly regrets it. and then the kaiju appear. Two giant kaiju begin to attack everyone at the dance, and panic ensues. They tear up the roof and start going after the people, presumably looking for Duncan, who's out in the hallways. Kenny shows some courage and vindicates himself by distracting the kaiju so everyone can escape. But he would end up captured, and right before he meets his demise, Duncan shows up to save the day. Duncan lures the two kaiju out to the desert to fight them so no one can get hurt, but his mom as well as Jenny follow them. But before they join Duncan, they notify and bring along Balak, who was unaware of the kaiju's Abaddon and Azeroth's actions. Duncan begins to engage with the two kaiju, and at first he puts up a good fight and would even grow a pair of wings, but he still ends up overpowered and in danger. Luckily though, Balak comes to help Duncan out just in time and gives him some relief. Unfortunately, it seems as though the king of the kaiju isn't who he once was and is dismantled by the other two kaiju. His axe, however, give Duncan enough time to come up with a plan. Duncan flies up a very high mountain with snow and ice on the top of it, and would then create an avalanche to subdue Abaddon and Azeroth. Fortunately, Balak and the others weren't harmed. Blitz and his cavalry end up taking Abaddon and Azeroth into detainment, as well as Balak, who voluntarily surrenders so he can finally be close with his family. I hope you really enjoyed my brief summary of the film, but let me tell you what I really liked and what I took away from it. Firebreather, on the surface, is a coming-of-age film about identity and accepting who you are, but it's also about fathers and how they affect us. Throughout the film, we see how the dynamic of fatherhood is in play. Duncan, Kenny, Troy all have complicated relationships with their fathers, for better or for worse. And luckily for Duncan, by the end of the film, he has a better understanding of his father, and potentially gets to truly know him before losing him like Jenny. Well, that's my interpretation anyway. This film isn't perfect. The animation and CGI didn't age too well, and it reminded me of Monster House, but cheaper. I really enjoyed the pacing, with the film only being just over an hour, but certain parts did seem rushed. All in all, it was a good film and I really enjoyed it nonetheless. If you made it this far, please hit that like and subscribe button, and feel free to leave some constructive criticism or even just hate in the comments. See ya.